Good morning, Patrick Henry. Happy Friday. It's great to be here with you all. I hope you're having a good week so far. We're going to kick off Friday morning meeting today with fifth grader Oakley Joe Lamberta. He has our VIP speech for the day.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good morning, teachers, students, and staff. My name is Oakley Joe Edward Lamberta. I am here to talk about promptness. Promptness is defined as the quality of doing something quickly and without delay, or at the arranged time. It is important because if you always are on time and doing things quickly and without delay, people can rely on you. Reliability is a result of being prompt. Lately, I have had some troubles with promptness, and I am trying to fix them right now. If I do not fix them, I will get bad grades, and my teacher will stop relying on me. It would make me feel really sad if my teachers didn't rely on me. I have always thought of myself as a good student, and to see my recent struggles with promptness all affecting my grades, it is not cool. Once I was prompt to my football practice, and my coach was very happy, so he let me take a break from warm-ups. This type of experience reminds me to always try my best at being prompt. Ways to improve promptness are being on time and doing work before the due date. If you find yourself struggling with promptness, you should carve out time to do the work that you are missing. Sometimes you just have to believe in yourself and you will prevail. Unfortunately, it is time for me to go. Have a nice Friday. Thanks for listening. Bye.
All right. This is Miss Yaz's class. Everybody give a wave. Hello, everyone. So we are presenting our famous Americans projects for everyone. So Lucia, would you start us off, please?
Hi, I am Maggie Walker, and I was born in 1864 in Richmond, Virginia, where I lived my entire life. I was the first African-American woman to own a bank and the first African-American woman to be the president of a bank. I was a very good storyteller. My favorite topics were race, pride, women's problems, and potential in African-American business. I helped inspire the African-American community and especially women. Thank you.
Thank you, Lucia. Next up is Nijah.
Hi, I'm Oprah Winfrey. I was born in 1954 in Nashville, Tennessee. Despite being demoted from my first job, I became a media mogul. I used to have my own show, and now I have my own TV station. It's called the OWN, Oprah Winfrey Network. I have my own magazine. It's called the Oprah Magazine. The end.
Thank you, Nijah.
You're welcome.
Next up is Juliet.
Hi, I'm Rosa Parks. I was born in Tuskegee, Alabama, February 4th, 1913. On December 1st, 1955, I got on the bus and I sat down, and then a white person came on the bus. The seats for white people were full, and three other people in IRACs to move. I said, no, I did not move. I got arrested. A bus boycott started on December 5th. It lasted for over a year. The plan was to boycott until the laws were changed and we didn't have to move for white riders. On November 13th, 1956, the Supreme Court said that segregation was not fair. The bus boycott ended on December 20th.
Thank you, Juliet. Next is Ava.
Hello, I'm Helen Keller. I was born in Alabama, June 1880. One day, I got very, very sick. I survived, but I was blind and deaf. I learned how to communicate without seeing or hearing.
Thank you, Ava. Next is Nevaeh.
Helen Keller was born June 27, 1880, until she died, until June 1st, 1968. She was 87 when she died.
That's perfect, Nevaeh, since you and Ava both did Helen Keller, so that's perfect. Thank you, Nevaeh. Next is Sarah.
Rosa Parks. Rosa Parks, Montgomery, Alabama, 1915-19. She didn't move, give the Percy on the bus. She helped with, she moved on. She died natural the 24th of October, Constance Secretary.
Thank you, Sarah. Next up is Liam.
I am Ben Franklin. I was born January 17th, 1706, Boston, Massachusetts. I got out of school at the age of 10 because my parents could not afford it. I came up with the theory of electricity. So I had a kite, and the lightning struck the kite, and the kite had a key attached to it, and the electricity would go to the key, and the key had a wire attached to it that would go down to a jar to hold the electricity. I also invented a lightning rod, and I helped write the Declaration of Independence.
Thank you, Liam. Next up is Ezra.
Hi, I'm Henry Ford. I was born on July 30th, 1863 in Michigan. I once made a steam whistle to scare my sister. I also grew up on a farm. I was famous for founding the Ford Motor Company and creating the assembly line. This is a sequence that made things cheaper and faster.
That's okay. Thank you, Ezra. All right. Next up is Will.
I'm 16 years. I was born February 1st, 1902 in Missouri. In the eighth grade, I was made Collapse Pollet. I went to Columbia University in 1921. In 1926, my first books of poem was published, The Rary Blues. I also went to Lincoln University as the first Black writer in the United States to make a living off my work. I wrote plays, short stories, and over 60 volumes of poem. My true love is writing.
Thank you, Will. Next up is Kennedy.
Welcome to my wax display. I am Ruby Bridges. I was born on September 8, 1954 in Tylertown, Mississippi. I was the first African American to integrate an elementary school in the South. On my first day, for the rest of the year, I was escorted by four federal marshals to school. None of the teachers wanted me in their class except for Barbara Henry. I was her only student. Although I was older and had things thrown at me by the mean, I showed courage and never cried. I marched along like a little soldier. Racism is a grown-up disease, and we must stop using our children to spread it. Always show love and kindness to one another. Thank you for visiting my wax display.
Thank you, Kennedy. Next up is Tristan.
I am George Washington Carver. I was born on January 1st on a farm in Diamond, Missouri. I am known for developing hundreds of products using peanuts. I also helped poor Southern farmers vary their crops and improve their diets. I was the first African American to enroll at Iowa State University. Then later, I received 2 degrees.
Awesome. Thank you, Tristan. And thank you to my class for presenting. Can you guys wave bye? Thank you all for listening to our presentations. Hope you all have a great weekend.
Thank you, Oakley Joe. That was really well done. We appreciate all your hard work. And thank you to Mr. Burke for helping once more with our VIP speeches and helping our speakers. So we appreciate you very, very much for that. Thank you to our class for the presentation. And we hope that you enjoyed it. I'm moving on now to our Katchas for the week. This is my favorite part. I love recognizing our students, so teachers and staff, keep them coming. These are from Miss Payton, and she would like to recognize Emir, Angelica, Zoe, Skyla, Adam, Gabriella, Emma, and Harmony. Orson is not a fan of working with his camera on, but he's always ready and willing to share his thoughts creatively. For the other students, Emir, Angelica, Zoe, Skyla, Adam, Gabriella, Emma, and Harmony, they're being recognized for being consistently on time to class. They have their cameras on, their materials ready, and they are frequently participating. So thank you for that, students. You're doing a great job, all of you. Miss Walker and Miss Holland, Miss Payton would like to thank you for all of your hard work. You do an amazing job for our students, and we are so grateful for you. You are team players, you're assisting with the development of the third graders, and you always go the extra mile to attend meetings, stay after classes, and have materials and lessons ready for each new day. They are truly amazing, Miss Walker and Miss Holland. You are truly amazing. And Miss Payton doesn't know what we would do without you. And here's some good news from Miss Payton's class. As you all know, they are avid readers on EPIC, and they also participate in Reflex Math. And Miss Payton's class has now read over 1,500 books on EPIC. That is amazing. And they have solved over 18,000 math problems on Reflex Math. You guys are doing such a great job. You are knocking the ball out of the park. Keep it up. And other classes, should you care to participate and compete with Miss Payton, she's really got a high bar. So you're going to have to work hard, but it can be done. Miss Payton is very proud of her continued good work. So thank you, Miss Payton. There's a lot of good things going on in your classroom, and it's very exciting to hear. Miss Brookman has a CAUCHA, and she would like to catch Desi Dumas in fourth grade and Simone Robinson, also in fourth grade, because they always attend their sessions with Miss Bell. They are actively engaged in the lessons, and they work very, very hard when they go to see her. So thank you to Desi and Simone for doing such a great job, and thanks to Miss Brookman for catching you. Miss Evans would like to thank her entire kindergarten class for always being eager to participate and being open and honest and for putting a smile on Miss Evans' face every single day. You are a delightful class, and Miss Evans appreciates you for being such great students, and she loves being your teacher. She just wanted you to know that. Great job, Miss Evans' class. These are from Miss George in kindergarten. She is recognizing Wilson Bright for making connections with his asynchronous reading lessons and their small group math lessons. He is finding patterns everywhere now. Miss George is catching Mr. Godsey, our wonderful music teacher. While Miss George was teaching sound patterns this week, every small group brought up that they find sound patterns in music class using T-Ta. Thanks for making them excited about music. And it's really transferring into the classroom. Great job, Mr. Godsey and students. Thank you. Miss George is also recognizing DJ Battle. DJ is an awesome reader. He reads with expression during small groups. He's always able to make a text-to-self connection. And that is so important. You are growing in leaps and bounds, DJ. Congratulations on your reading success. Keep it up. All right, those are Miss George's. We have some from Miss Hamlet. She would like to recognize Layla and Amira. They have really been on a roll. Their hard work is paying off and their grades are going up. You can really tell they're learning through their use of content vocabulary in class. Good job. Violet is almost always on camera. She almost always has her camera on. She participates and thinks deeply and is creative with her problem solving. Nice job, Violet. Benny's Black History presentation was fabulous. His artwork was awesome. You could tell he put a lot of thought and time into his project. Congratulations, Benny. Aiden has been working really hard this quarter to get his grades up, and he shares his enthusiasm with his class. The other day, we were having some friendly competition between the three groups, and Aiden was really cheering his team on. That's great to hear, Aiden. Please continue to do that good work. Deshaun was out of town, but he did not miss a minute of class. He made sure he had his materials, and even though he was not home, he made sure that his work was turned in on time. And that is the diligence that we hope to see and the leadership that we love to see in our fifth grade students. So Deshaun, great job, and good job to all of those students in Ms. Hamlet's fifth grade class. Those are the coaches for the week, so that brings our meeting to a close. We just want to thank the SCC for preparing our spring tea materials that were picked up this past week. You all received a mug and a few other things that you will be able to use on April the 2nd for your spring tea, so just set those aside. But thank you to our School Culture and Climate Committee for putting all of that together. And thanks to all the teachers for getting our materials ready for the package pickup this week. You all are phenomenal, and it's great to see that our students have everything that they need to learn at home. So thank you for the hard work that you all put in with that. And with that, I will wish you all a happy Friday and a great weekend. Take care, everyone. We'll see you next week.